So there are three technical components which we think are the essence of good imaging in OCT. And sometimes we like to call that the spectralis DNA. The first of these is confocal optics, followed by TrueTrack active eye tracking, and then the art of OCT, which is automatic real-time meaning or averaging of our OCT B scans. So let's talk about confocal optics. Unbeknownst to you, there's a very special advantage that you have just in the optics of the camera of your spectralis. So let's look at the image that we can get using confocal optics with our scanning laser. And you can see that this is an infrared reflectance image. And confocal optics gives you specially enhanced contrast and detail. And this is a structural diagnostic image. You almost can see the detail of the nerve fiber layer axons here. So the quality of information right from the beginning is exceptional. And you can see pathology immediately just by looking on this infrared image. And you can move your OCT exactly to the location that you need to in order to document the condition of the fundus. Confocal optics has other advantages. You can actually get into very small pupils, and so this is very useful for diabetic patients, because diabetic patients don't dilate very well and they're hard to image. So there's an advantage just in confocal optics to examine diabetic patients. Also, you avoid scattered light from cataract. The confocal principle means that we only take the information from the point of focus, and so you're only capturing the information that you need, and you don't use the unwanted light that's scattered by the cataract. So you're much better for diabetic patients, and you're much better for cataract patients, and also any patient with a corneal condition, because that also has the effect of scattering the light. And this brings us to TrueTrack active eye tracking, or live eye tracking. This is a feature that was developed by Heidelberg Engineering for the spectralis, and you can show this very nicely if we move our fundus image up close to our OCT. You can see how exactly the fundus image aligns. If we look at the shadows of the OCT vessels here, exactly aligns to the fundus image. So we always know the location of the OCT relative to our fundus image. And this gives us such a high reproducibility when we look on follow-up. And remember, we're tracking the eye live all the time. So all the time we know the location of the OCT relative to the fundus. And so I'm in position, I'm going to acquire. And we're done. If you want to do a super quick scan, we could select Art 1. And this would be super fast, and let's see how quickly that one runs. It's done, it's really super fast. In fact, the patient has no time to move away from the scan. So let me show you, slowed down, what really is happening with regard to our live eye tracking. So I'm going to select a nice posterior pole scan here. We're doing an averaging of 9 frames per B scan. And that's possible because of the ability of our TrueTrack live eye tracking. So we start the scan, and maybe I ask my patient to move away, and you see how the scan stops because the instrument doesn't recognize anymore the retina, and so we stop scanning. And if I ask my patient to come back in position, we catch up exactly where we left off and continue to track the eye live. So we're tracking the eye live all the time. It doesn't really matter if your patient only has confrontation vision. We're always going to know the location of the OCT relative to the fundus image, even if they move. So let's come back to our patient with the vitreomacular traction, and think about the follow-up. So, first of all, how are you going to come back to exactly the same location with your OCT? You can see that disappears. It's pretty tricky, right? So let's look at a follow-up scan and see how that works. We're going to do a baseline scan and then do a follow-up scan and show you the reproducibility. So I'm acquiring my scan and we're done. So let's save that scan. So now let's do the follow-up. Okay, that's good. We can actually see both the baseline exam here and the follow-up exam here in the same window, and we can flick between the two exams. We can magnify and see what the difference is between the two exams, and we can review our retina. And if you notice, if I move to this location of that vessel, you can see the shadow of the vessel, and you can see that it absolutely stable and doesn't move between the baseline and the follow-up exam. So you know you have a reliable follow-up. And let's see how repeatable that actually is. If I go to print report here, and so here we have our baseline exam, here we have our follow-up exam, and if we zoom in, you can see the difference map, and every sector here is within 0 or 1 micron reproducibility. Let's have a look at this patient here, which seems to have some pathology, looks like a macular hole from the infrared reflectance image. And if we look on the OCT, we can see very nicely that it looks like a full thickness macular hole. We can magnify and look in great detail. We can see that the external limiting membrane is still preserved, and so there's a good possibility that if we can get the retina back in position, that patient might recover some vision. So with our eye tracking, we did a follow-up scan, and so here's the follow-up scan, and you can see that the patient actually, the retina is back in position, and the external limiting membrane is nicely in position, and we can flick between the baseline and the follow-up exam. And if you notice here, this shadow from this vessel between the baseline and the follow-up, it doesn't move, and so you can be confident that those scans are very accurate, and you can track a follow-up scan very well. Not only that, in this case you can show your patient how nicely that procedure went, and maybe the reason why their vision came back. So we have our beautiful confocal infrared reflectance image, and we can run our OCT through any position that we want depending where we see pathology. And we obtain an equally beautiful OCT scan, and you can magnify that scan, and you can see the level of detail from this vitreous traction. You can see all the layers of the retina very clearly, right to the outer retina and on into the choroid. And we're doing here an averaging of 100 B scans within our image. So we call that ARC 100. So we can segment all layers of the retina here, and so you can see the segmentation right the way down to Bruch's membrane RPE level. So here you can see a patient which is very obviously much more disrupted retina, and of course if we look on the OCT scan you can see why. But notice the detail from the vitreous right the way through the neurosensory retina, all the way through the choroid, right down to the sclera. And this again is another ARC 100 image, so we've got 100 individual B scans within our complete image. And that gives us that contrast and detail within the OCT scan. So the Spectralis is a true multimodal platform. You have many imaging modes that you can compare and complement each other all in the same location, and that means that you don't have to move your patient around the clinic, so this might help with your practice efficiency or your clinic workflow. And in addition to that, it's an upgradable platform, so you can start at the most basic level and you still have the benefit of Spectralis DNA, and you can add modules as and when you need them or as and when budget becomes available. So you're never out of date, and you can say Spectralis truly is a future-proof investment platform.